convocation of the institute is about to begin. The academic procession is now entering the hall. You are requested to stand up and remain standing till all the members of the procession are seated. Thank you.
I request Chairman BOG to declare the convocation open.
Namaskar, I declare this convocation of IIT Ropar open.
I request Director Professor Rajiv Ahuja to present the Institute report.
So, I welcome all of you and all students who are passing out and their parents who are here to see the achieve what their kids or their son or their daughters have achieved in IIT Ropar. They can witness now. So I will start with esteemed guest, parents and parents of the graduating batch, my colleagues, and dear students, good morning. It's my honor to address you today on the occasion of the 12th convocation of the IIT Ropar. As the director of IIT Ropar, I am proud to witness the culmination of your hard work. Congratulations. Friends, the year 2023 has been remarkable for us. We have achieved several milestones regarding the new academic programs, cutting-edge R&D, global research collaborations, and meaningful investment in the infrastructure and the faculty recruitment. As we celebrate your achievements today, I would like to highlight some of your remarkable accomplishments. Our students have excelled in various fields, from academic and research to building the deep tech startups and the community service. You have represented IIT Ropar at the national as well as international competition, winning recognition for your talents. We are proud that our alumni network is growing with over 3,000 graduates employed globally. As the graduating student of this year, you joined the league. We wish you all the best and warmly wait to hear about your journey ahead. As we move forward, we remain committed to providing high quality education and research opportunities to our students. Our faculty members are recognized globally for fundamental and outcome oriented research. With a focus on research and innovation, we are investing to set up the state of the art infrastructure and facilities for the world class learning experience at the IIT Ropar. As we conclude this convocation, I want to remind you that the real education is a balanced blend of acquiring knowledge and developing character and values. This will guide you throughout your lives. I urge you to continue learning, growing, and contributing to the society. Proud parents and dear guests, on the behalf of the IIT Ropar, thank you for your support and trust in this institute. Once again, congratulations to all graduating batch. May your future will be filled with the success, happiness, and fulfillment. As a customary, I will now present a brief report of the IIT Ropar. Starting with the academics today, at this convocation, 615 students are graduating, including 305 BTech, 67 MSc students, 116 MTech, 115 PhDs, and 12 BTech, MTech dual degree students. This year, we have more than 3,000 students on the campus, comprising of the 1,517 UG students, 539 PG students, 920 PhDs, and 14 dual degree students and research interns, as well as the project fellow. In the current year, 31 foreign national has been admitted to IIT Ropar for PG and PhD program in a different schemes. I'm happy to share that female employment at IIT Ropar has increased eightfold as compared to 2018 and 2019. IIT Ropar has been certified as a Eat Right campus recently. Inspired by preventive healthcare, the Eat Right campus is an initiative of FSSAI in the framework of the National Health Policy of 2017 to promote safe, healthy, and sustainable food in campuses. So we have got the 5-star rating for this. To match the requirement of the industry, working in the domain of AI-powered intelligent system, IIT Ropar is going to offer minor in AI to all branches in the framework of our open to all initiative announced on the 15th Foundation Day. In the recent year, our research quality has significantly increased, with the average citation per paper is 18.36 and with H index of 92. This ranks us one of the best among Tier 1 institutes in the country. During the current year, colleagues at Ropar have published more than 900 research papers in high-ranking international journals. The institute has attracted high-quality students, faculty members to lead innovative research projects in the diverse area of science and technology. The number of PhD students on the campus is now 1:5 faculty to PhD student ratio. In 2023, IIT Ropar ranked 22nd in engineering category and 33rd in the overall category by NRF. The institute entered the first time in a research ranking and we ranked 46th in the quantum of research. Further, the institute has been ranked number one globally in the graduate quality index. As per the research work of Jeff Horwich, senior economist, writer at the Federal Reserve Bank of Minneapolis, the graduate of the IIT Ropar have not just been found the best in India, they have also been reported to be the most promising student on the planet, as measured by their earning potential. Fulfilling our academic commitments, IIT Ropar has set up different COEs, Center of Excellence for Interdisciplinary Education and Research. The COEs, for example, the Center for Engineering Education, which aims to carry out the engineering education, research, curriculum development, and education management. This is the only one such kind of center in all 23 IITs. Center for Study and Applied Research in the Defense and Security, working closely with the armed forces of the country. With the Punjab Police, we are setting up an AI lab at IIT Ropar to solve the real-world problems related to the law and enforcement. Center for Rural Technology and Skills for the advancing of the rural technology ecosystem and the scale. Then we have a Center for Research in Energy Efficiency and Decarbonization. There is a Center of Excellence we have in Thermal Spray Coating, jointly supported by DST Applied Materials and Metallizing Equipment Company. We have started an IIT Ropar Alumni Center in Bengaluru, dedicated for the promoting innovation, entrepreneurship, and positive social impact through the various programs and initiatives. Recently, the state of the Punjab has also sanctioned as the Center of Excellence in Sustainable Mining. The career development and placement cell at the institute is pivotal in facilitating the professional growth and placement opportunities for our students. In the time of the global showdown, IIT Ropar receives 134 companies on the campus this year. 73% of IIT Ropar UG students are already placed at an average package of the 23 lakhs. External funding is like a fuel for R&D at IIT Ropar. IIT Ropar is actively engaged in various R&D projects supported by different funding agencies. We have more than 500 R&D projects with the outlay of 350 plus crore and 600 industrial consultancy projects with the tune of the 40 crore plus. Recently, the Ministry of Education approved the phase one of the mega project to set up a Center of Excellence in Agriculture. I'm happy to note that IIT Ropar is one of the two institutions in the country which has been declared successful for the AI mission. Our DST Technology Innovation Hub, Awadh, has been recognized as one of the best performing hub in the country, and the IIT Ropar is as the most promising institution in the agri-tech with development of the 56 advanced technologies resulting in 43 technology projects and 100 IPs and publications. Adding to the mega projects portfolio, the institute, the Ministry of Textile and the Ministry of Earth Science has approved the projects of worth 30 crore to the institute. Further, to add the value of achievement and R&D ecosystem in the institute, IIT Ropar has entered in the cooperation with Baikal Tech. It's a UK-based company who is going to set up a HCP, high-performance computing, for joint research in 5G and AI for the security and the law enforcement application. The University of Oulu, Finland, we have signed an MOU for the joint research activities with ICMR, CO BED, at PGI Chandigarh for healthcare innovation And we have also signed a joint degree program for research and other areas with Uppsala University in Sweden. NSDC, this is a national skill development for running the skill development courses for skilling, reskilling, and upskilling the ever-growing human resources in the country so that they can efficiently contribute the Atmanirbhar Bharat. Punjab Municipal City for the capacity building and training programs to address the urban infrastructure challenges, making the cities more sustainable and resilient. And then we have also with Applied Materials USA for exploring the innovative application of materials for critical importance in the semiconductor industry. Samsung Electronics for focusing on machine learning and data science and for the digital health. Punjab Energy Development Agency is set up to agri-PV station at IIT Ropar. The five central universities of the northern India in Jammu, Haryana, Himachal, Punjab and Rajasthan, and IIT Ropar has established a MOU, a Memorandum of Understanding. And this is the first of this kind in India, where IIT Ropar is going to lead five central universities around us. We have assigned, we are working also with the Ordnance Factory Chandigarh to design and develop the day vision optical devices and the communication system. With DART Germany, we are promoting the R&Ds and academic and cultural cooperation between India and Germany. So we are going to have another center with the Indian Navy to foster R&D and Made in India defense technology. Ministry of Home Affairs to conduct the skilling and training, capacity building, operational research and technical study at the national level. So this is a huge project also from the Ministry of Home Affairs. We are also signed the agreement with the University of La Rolette in France, Mid-Sweden University in Sweden, Institute of Technology from in Indonesia, the University of Oulu, Finland, TSU, Russia, Serbian State Medical University, Russia for the academic collaboration. So delegation from Dalhousie University, Canada, Asia University, Taiwan, National Chung Chen University from Taiwan, South Dakota from US, Kaohsiung Medical University, RPI from US, and Mid-Sweden University visited IIT Ropar for this year to explore the R&D possibility. For the coming summer, we have introduced a special internship program for national and international students. At the institute, we have created a supportive and inclusive environment where students can thrive academically, socially, and emotionally. Adding to the academy and research, we have established Snehita, a well-being cell to support the mindfulness of the resident of the campus. Our student community is supported by one of its kind outdoor adventure and social activity club. Different clubs organize technical, cultural support and literary festival along these other activities. And today, maybe if you are staying here, you will have join this Kavi Sammelan also. This is a part of the this literary event what students are doing this year. So we are offering our students very vibrant startup ecosystem. Our mission is enable and empower researchers and students to build deep tech startups covering a wide variety of technologies and innovation. The institute has started the Samriddhi Startup Conclave for the acceleration of the market-ready innovation in collaboration with DST to foster sustainable deep tech agriculture and water technology startups. As you know, the institute started functioning at the present campus in 2017-18 session in the phase-wise manner, marking the completion of the phase one. The Prime Minister Modi ji has dedicated the campus to the nation on 20th February 2024. Through our NGO, Pehchan, IIT Ropar elevates the unprivileged school student to achieve academic excellence, acquire necessary skills, and confidently pursue their educational goals despite the limited resources. Some of the initiatives of our NGO are the school Safar Sathi, evening Pathshala, mobile STEM lab, and support to the Atal Teacher Training Program. So now I get closer to my concluding remarks. Friends, we celebrate your graduation today. I am filled with pride and joy. You have spent your days and nights at IIT Ropar, receiving an education comparable to the best in the world. You are now ready to take on more significant challenges in life. I do not doubt that you will shine and contribute greatly to the humankind and harmony with the nature. While I congratulate you on this momentous occasion, I underline the sacrifices made by your parents and family members in seeing you achieve this success. The education which you have received at IIT Ropar is not just a degree, but a tool to bring harmony to the society as individuals. We gave you an education that goes beyond academic knowledge and encourage the development of your character, intellect, and the skills. As you step out from this institute today, as a proud alumnus of IIT Ropar, I urge you to uphold the core value of the integrity, merit, excellence, freedom of thoughts. We will always look to you for a strong association and shall cherish the relationship throughout our existence. So my dear graduating student, I wish you all a true success in your life. Let the motto of the IIT Ropar, Dhiyo Yona Prachodayat, be your guiding light as you embark to the new chapter of the life. Thank you, all of you, and Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
I welcome the Chairman Sri Adil Siraj Sainulbhai to the convocation. Adil is the Chairman of the Capacity Building Commission of India, which was set up by the Honorable Prime Minister of India in April 2021. He has also served as the Chairman of the Quality Council of India from 2014 to 2020. He is in the board of Network 18, TV 18, Reliance Industries Limited, Tarson and Turbo and Cipla. As a Chairman of the Capacity Building Commission, he leads the commission in executing vision of the Honorable Prime Minister, the Mission Karma Yogi, to help the civil servants to deliver performance for the citizens of India. As a chairman of the Quality Council of India, Mr. Sainulbhai was involved in many initiatives across the government to improve the quality of the goods and service and the efficiency of the government process. Mr. Sainulbhai retired as the chairman of McKinsey in India in 2013. After 34 years of service in McKinsey in the United States of America. Sainulbhai grew up in Mumbai and graduated in mechanical engineering from IIT Mumbai, and he also holds a MBA degree from Harvard Business School. So we are very privileged you, sir, have as a chairman. Now I request the chairman to deliver the address.
Professor Ahuja, my good friend, Dr. Pawan Goenka, who has had an incredible career that you'll hear about a little later, although I'll give you one short anecdote. The Senate members, deans, heads of departments, students, and parents. Namaskar. It's always very interesting to come back to IIT. So I want to tell you a little bit about some of the experiences that I had at IIT. Both as a student and as an alumni. So I'll start out by saying that I graduated in 1977 with mechanical engineering. And I didn't go back to the IIT Bombay campus for 25 years. You were asking yourself, why? Was it so traumatic that I didn't want to return? Or was it just, you know, the fact that I was in the US? Or the fact that I was not able to attend my convocation and I didn't get my degree till after 25 years? But, you know, this is how life works. I wanted to tell you about two of my experiences at IIT that shaped me and helped enormously, but also are part of being part of IIT. Okay, I guess you have exams here, right? Do you have exams, tests, quizzes? I want you to think about the worst exam you ever had in your life at IIT. Can you think? Was it terrible? Was it horrible? Was it Professor Ahuja's exam? Okay, so I want to give you what I went through, and I won't name names because that's not fair, because they were the best professors at IIT at that time. In a hall like this, in one of the subjects in our first year that everybody had to take, We walked in for this test and started reading. There were only 7 questions on the test. The first person walked out of the room after 10 minutes and said, I don't understand any of the questions. I don't know how I'm going to answer this, so I'll walk out. I think 3 people left IIT as a result of the test. The gold medalist, who is doing brilliantly around the world today, and I won't name the person, but he has done, he's had positions in Berkeley, Stanford, MIT, etc., got 27 out of 100. I don't want to tell you what my score was, but it was not 0, okay? So, you know, at the end of that and other events like this, you start thinking, you know, really, is this for me? You know, is this worth it? You know, do I need to go through many of these? The good news was that we were friends with a lot of people in 3rd, 4th, 5th year. At that time, IIT was 5 years long. And they said to us, don't worry, everybody goes through this. You know, you'll only have 1 or 2 exams like this, but it is meant to really test you. And I have to say, it really tested us. And our IIT experiences are unique in the level of intensity, in the level of testing that it does, and I think it will serve you really well for the rest of your life, as it did for me. So that was my first interesting experience at IIT. The second part that I want to talk about in IIT is what I did after I left. I started out in chemical engineering and I visited a refinery. I know the professors of chemical engineering here and you may have heard my story. I started out in chemical engineering and for a summer job I was at a refinery, and as I was walking around the refinery I realized that there were more mechanical engineers in a chemical plant than there are chemical engineers. And at that time, we all worried about jobs. And I said, you know, maybe mechanical is better. And so that's how I wound up in mechanical. And I didn't do a day's worth of work in mechanical engineering in the last 40 years. But, you know, in a sense, this is what IIT is. It teaches you to think. Doesn't matter what the discipline is. It taught me to think. It taught me to take risks. It taught me to do many things in addition to teaching me physics and all of that. But where you wind up is not necessarily what you planned, is what I was going to say. Today, 30 years later, and I want you to take a look around you, because the batch in which you graduated and probably the hostel in which you stayed will be your best friends for 50 years. Pawan and I graduated at a time, and if we look back to who are our best friends today after 50 years, it's the set of people that we spent time with in the hostel together for 5 years or 4 years now. I don't know, Pawan, if that is true for you, but it is certainly true for me. And so please take a look around you. Some of these folks are going to be your friends for 30, 40, 50 years, and they will be fantastic friends. Our class that graduated in 77, and I just want to remind you of what it was like at that stage. At that stage, there were 5 IITs with 1,500 graduates. Today, there's 23 IITs with 18,000 or 19,000 people graduating. The best job that you could get when you graduated from IIT in engineering at that time was at L&T for 1,000 rupees a month. Okay, that was the best job you could get. Not many other jobs that were out there. India's GDP per capita was about $186 per capita. Today it's $2,400. And I'm going to come back to that. So we all left. Many of our class, I think 50% of my class, left to go international. And we studied in the US. We were all successful. But what is very interesting is that of the people who went to the US, 90% of them either have huge investments in India or are working in India, like me. It's a very, you know, none of us expected this, but this is how life changes. And I've come back now, and with Board of Governors of IIT, I'm very involved with IIT Bombay. But it changes a lot, and a lot of people, a lot of what you see in venture capital coming in today are a set of people who graduated from IITs in the 70s and 80s who did really well and are coming back and investing in India, or private equity, or large companies. So I want you to think a little bit about, I have a very short speech because I know everyone wants to get their degrees and go for lunch. Right? So all I will say is, I wish I were graduating today. When I was graduating, there were hardly any jobs available. I think today, the opportunities for you, even though this is a tough season, I recognize this is a tough season, so yes, we accept that. The opportunities today are incredible. Just to give you one example, I think in 1977 in India, there were 20 startups. This year, we have 100,000 startups. GDP of India was 121 billion. Today it's 3 trillion on our way to 10 trillion. The next 15 to 20 years, when you will be in the peak of your career, will be a chance to shape India as India reaches middle income levels and reaches developed countries. There is nothing as exciting as being part of something at the creation, whether it is a company, whether it is a country. When you're in the phase of development, when things are growing, there is nothing as exciting as that. I know some of you are going to go in startups. Even if it fails, there's nothing quite as exciting as that. When you're part of development of a country, when it is going through this kind of development, there is nothing as exciting as that. So you are in for very, very exciting times. I don't think, as some of the smartest people in India who got in here through a very tough JEE program, went through 4 years of very tough exams and schedules, you should want that the next 15, 20 years should be easy for you. You are too talented to do something that's easy. What you should do are things that are difficult and things that will help you, your family, and the country. And I think the opportunities to do that are phenomenal. That's why I wish I could graduate again today and start my whole career all over again. At the age of 70, you know, I don't think I have a 30-year career in front of me, so I can't do some of those things. But this is really a fantastic time. So I want to end by saying congratulations to the parents for having lived through this. I know many, many years you all worked very hard to put them through JEE. Congratulations to all the students because you all were all crazy enough to study for the JEE. And congratulations on surviving through 4 years of IIT or 6 years as the PhDs and M.Tech for 2 years, and you're now going into a world that has phenomenal opportunities in India and the rest of the world. And I look forward to seeing your successes many, many years from now. Thank you.
Hello, good morning. I welcome to this convocation Dr. Sri Pavan Kumar Goenka ji. Before I go to his brief bio, I would like to share with you that we meet Dr. Pavan Goenka quite every day. And when I will complete the introduction of Dr. Pavan Goenka, you will get to know why I said this. Dr. Pavan Goenka earned his B.Tech degree in mechanical engineering from IIT Kanpur and PhD from Cornell. He is also a graduate of Advanced Management Program from Harvard Business School. He worked at General Motors R&D Center in Detroit, USA, from 1979 to 1993. Dr. Goenka joined Mahindra & Mahindra Limited in 1993 at General Manager Research and Development and led the development of the Scorpio SUV. So that's why I said we meet him quite every day. Dr. Goenka is credited with building a strong R&D infrastructure, a robust product portfolio for Mahindra, and is widely recognized as a statesman of Indian auto industry. Dr. Goenka served on the boards of several Mahindra Group companies, both domestic and international. He retired from Mahindra as a managing director and CEO on 1st April 2021. Dr. Goenka has received several awards, such as the Bert L. Newkirk Award, Charles L. McQueen Achievement Award, the Physita Medal of Honor, Automotive Man of the Year Award, CV Man of the Year, Lifetime Achievement Award, and Param Shrestha Award. Dr. Goenka was also honored with the Lifetime Achievement Award for his unparalleled contribution to the automotive industry by the Automotive Component Manufacturers Association, ACMA, in March 2022. Dr. Goenka received the Distinguished Alumni Award from IIT Kanpur in 2004 and was also conferred with the Doctor of Science degree in 2015. He is a fellow of SAE International and the Indian National Academy of Engineers and a member of National Academy of Engineers, USA. Dr. Goenka is past president of SIAM, of Society of Automotive Engineers in India, the ARAI Governing Council, and served as a board member of National Skill Development Corporation, NSDC, and a member of Confederation of Indian Industry, National Council. He is currently serving as the chairman of the Board of Governors of IIT Madras. Dr. Goenka is the chairperson of Indian National Space Promotion and Authorization Center in Space, Department of Space, Government of India, and of the Steering Committee for Advancing Local Value Add and Exports Scale, an initiative under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Dr. Goenka also served as an independent director on the board of Sun Pharmaceutical Industries Limited and Bosch Limited. With this, I welcome Dr. Goenka for his convocation speech. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Singh. You could have shortened the bio a little bit. Oh. My good friend, Sri Adil Zuanbhai, the chairperson of Board of Governors of IIT Ropar, Professor Rajiv Ahuja, director of IIT Ropar, members of the Senate, deans, HODs, distinguished guests, my young friends graduating today, and their proud parents. It is a great pleasure for me to be here participating in the 12th convocation of Indian Institute of Technology, Ropar. Now, I'm in a little bit of an awkward situation because I prepared my speech not realizing that all of you had graduated almost a year ago. And therefore, some of what I say may be a little irrelevant. And therefore, please assume that this is June 9th, 2023, and not April 9th, 2023, as you listen to me. So, dear graduating class of 23, heartiest congratulations. Since the time you first walked through these halls of IIT Ropar, you and your family members must have been eagerly looking forward to this day, to adorn your graduation, not robe anymore, with pride, walk onto the dais with your head held high and receive the degree you have worked for so hard. I can imagine the pride and joy of your parents at this momentous occasion as they witness your graduation ceremony. I also see a similar pride and joy in the eyes of your teachers. Through their untiring efforts, they have created not just good engineers, but also shaped your young minds to make you better human beings. So I request you, the graduating class, to rise and give a standing ovation to your parents, some of who are here, some of you are listening remotely, and your teachers who have contributed towards your successful journey at IIT Ropar. Could you rise and give a standing ovation, please? Thank you, and my greetings to all the parents and all the teachers of these young students. It seems like yesterday, when IIT Ropar was born, in 2008, I think, and today, we are already celebrating the 12th convocation of this institute in a beautiful campus. How quickly the time has passed. The founding director, Professor Surappa, then Professor Das, and now Professor Ahuja, have led this institute to make it one of the highly rated, highly regarded institute amongst the new IITs. What I find remarkable is that the number of postgraduate students amongst the new number of postgraduate students here are almost equal to undergraduate students, which is a feat that took decades for the older IITs to achieve. And I was also impressed that in last year's NIRF ranking, IIT Ropar was ranked amongst the top, the number one, in quality of research. That is a remarkable achievement for a young IIT. I was also struck by the fact that the professors and even deans at this IIT are so young. Yesterday, when Professor Sarang received me at the airport and introduced himself as Dean of Continuing Education, I had to ask him again, because I was not sure that I heard him right. How can he be Dean already? If he was sitting amongst you, I would have thought that he would be graduating just like with you. But after all, IIT Ropar is like a startup. And a startup has many advantages to those who are part of the startup, because at a very young age, you get to do things that if you were in an older setup, will take you years to get to. And that's why the young faculty member here must be really enjoying their time at IIT Ropar, taking on very responsible position, which at older IITs, you'll have to have gray hair before you can get to that level. Now, Adil talked about his days at IIT. And I can almost say ditto and sit down. So let me also reminisce a little bit about many, many years ago, even a little longer than, a little far back than Adil, because I went into IIT Kanpur in 1970, before any of you sitting here were born, and graduated in 1975. Now, in my case, I came from a Hindi medium. And the first time I wrote an exam in English was the JEE exam for IIT, and barely got through. I remember ragging. In those days, ragging was officially allowed. Now it's not officially allowed, but I'm sure it happens. In ragging, I was asked, when did you come to the campus? And I quickly did my Hindi sentence and translated it. I said, I came here tomorrow. And you can imagine the kind of ragging I got after saying I came here tomorrow. Then I went to the chemistry class. Class of 400 students, taught by a professor of chemistry from MIT, Professor Davenport, in English, of course. And I didn't understand a single word of what he was saying. Just imagine, for the first time ever, a lecture in English, and that too by an American professor. And then I went to my math class, Dr. and Mrs. Tiwari, calculus class. And I had never done calculus before. And she was writing this dy upon dx. And I was wondering, why doesn't she cross out d and d and become y upon x, y dy upon dx. And I wanted to really go home. I called my father. I said, I cannot stand here. He said, no, doors are closed for you. You have to stay there. And I'm glad I did. Now, remember sitting where you are 49 years ago and thinking about the options in front of me. Adil talked about that. At that time, the prevailing sentiment was to seek opportunities abroad, to build a life beyond the borders of our nation. I went through the flow. I went through the same common drill. Get a PhD in US, get a job there, come back to India to find a life partner, get the green card, have kids, buy a house, and live happily thereafter. But something happened along the way that changed the course of my life. And there's a commonality again between your chairman, your director, and me. Each of us, after having spent 20 plus years in US, decided to come back, or US or Europe, decided to come back, giving up fat dollar salaries to modest Indian salaries. This, at that time, for my wife and me, was a decision made from the heart and not from the logical reasoning of the head. No Excel sheet calculation would have convinced me that it's the right thing for me to do in 1993. To move back from USA, giving up a job in General Motors, to India, working for a company which is unheard of called Mahindra & Mahindra. But when we look back, undoubtedly for my wife and I, this was the best decision we ever made, ever made. Thank you. So lesson number one from my life that I would like to communicate to you is sometimes let your heart overpower the head. We engineers are too much of left-brain thinkers. You should do what your heart desires. In the long run, that will make you happier. Having said that, let me also say that just doing what your heart desires is not enough to make you happier. There must be a bigger purpose that you are pursuing, what I often call a superordinate goal. That superordinate goal for me was given to me by Mr. Anand Mahindra when he hired me in Mahindra & Mahindra. He simply said, I want to be able to compete with the best in the world with homegrown products, homegrown suppliers, and homegrown manufacturing. All I ask you to do is give me that, whatever it takes. And that, my friends, became the superordinate goal for me, gave birth to Scorpio, and drove me for the next 20 plus years. When I came to India, global ranking of Indian automotive industry was 21. By the time I retired, it had moved up to number 3. And to be part of the journey of the industry, not because of me, to be part of that journey of the industry was the most gratifying part of my career. So I say to you that you must find your bigger purpose, the superordinate goal. It may not be obvious today what it is, but keep looking for it. You will see it someday right in front of your eyes, and that's going to change your whole life. Today, as Adil said, things are very different than what it was 50 years ago. The landscape has changed completely. Professor Ahuja, Adil, and I had to leave our country and come back. Today, you don't need to do so to fulfill your superordinate goal. But if you desire to go, and if you decide to go, nothing wrong with it. Today, the world is looking at India as a land of unique opportunities. There is immense optimism, immense confidence in the abilities of the young people of India, like you all. The Indian economy the Indian economy is moving at a great speed. 10 years ago, India was 10th largest economy in the world with a GDP of $1.9 trillion. Now we are number 5, poised to become number 3 in 3 more years with a GDP of $5 trillion and $13 trillion by 2047. Just imagine the kind of growth that India has seen right in front of our eyes in the last few years. India is today a preferred investment destination for many industries and presents opportunities like never before. This is leading to a remarkable transformation to a nation on the rise, a nation that dreams big and achieves even bigger. We are well on our path to become a Viksit Bharat, a developed India by 2047, the centenary of our independence. This is a national aspiration put forward by Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi. Some of you may have wondered, what is Viksit Bharat? Is it just a slogan, or does it really have a deeper meaning? And I want to spend a few minutes, because I think it's very relevant in your context. What Viksit means is developed. But although economic prosperity is undoubtedly a crucial aspect, Viksit Bharat is not just about economic prosperity. What we should aspire to see in Viksit Bharat by 2047 includes a country with a USD $30 trillion economy with more than 7-fold increase in per capita income. A country with world-class infrastructure and facility, both in urban and rural areas, such that the urban and rural divide is reduced to a thin line. A country where each and every citizen has access to basic quality healthcare and education, preferably free of cost. A country where poverty has been totally eradicated, illiteracy removed. A country which is fully self-reliant and is the global hub for all the critical technologies across the strategic sectors like defense, space, aerospace, and global manufacturing export hub for champion sectors like automotive, agriculture, food processing, chemicals, textiles. A country which is the best destination for the most talented scholars, scientists, and investors. A country with minimal interference by the government in the lives of citizens and run by the robust digital economy and governance. A country with energy independence through adoption of clean energy. Now that's what Viksit Bharat in 2047 would be. And isn't that a dream worth living for? Now you all will be at the peak of your career when India reaches the Viksit Bharat landmark in 2047. And for now, just close your eyes and imagine for a moment the India that you will be living in 2047 as a citizen of Viksit Bharat India. And that's a pretty picture that I think you all need to work for. Viksit Bharat will be possible only if the government, businesses, entrepreneurs, and young professionals like you take big bets. Take big bets. And this is the third learning that I want to communicate to you. Disruptions can be caused only by taking big bets, by taking risks. If you have never failed in anything, don't feel good about it. You have perhaps not failed because you have not taken big bets, because you have not taken risks in your life. And disruptions can happen, as I said, only if you take big bets. For me, coming back to India was a big bet. For my company, to invest in Scorpio, invest in electric vehicles, make large acquisitions were big bets. Some paid off handsomely, some didn't. But overall, the balance is in the favor of paying off. Today, India is placing big bets in groundbreaking technologies across digital, fintech, space research, health tech, and other areas. India would require a quantum leap to propel its developmental journey multiple folds ahead and transform itself into a developed nation. The road to Viksit Bharat will come from technology and innovation, and this is where you, the graduating class of 2023 of IIT Ropar, can play a big role. You can create the building blocks of inclusive growth by leveraging technology. India needs robust, accessible, and innovative technology solutions to improve the quality of life, to be on par with global standards, and in many cases, even define the new benchmarks globally. Young Indians like you are the ones who will bridge the gap between aspiration and reality. You will tackle the challenges of tomorrow, and you will transform this vision into action. Hence, my friends, the choices that you make from now on will have a profound and lasting impact, not just on your future and your career, but on the generations to come. You stand at a crossroad with a multiple of paths before you. Some of you may choose to delve deeper into the world of academia, pursuing higher education and unraveling the mysteries of science and technology or management. Or you may opt to join the industry, contributing your skills and knowledge to established organizations or dynamic startups. Many of you may even choose to make your own path and embrace entrepreneurship, creating new ventures to drive innovation and economic growth. Some of you may choose to leave the shores of a nation. But no matter what you do, no matter what path you choose, be socially responsible. Make sure that your skills and knowledge help to address the challenges faced by a nation. And remember that each of you has the power to shape the future of India, to take us to a vision of Viksit Bharat. And the last lesson that I want to communicate today to you may not be so relevant to you today, but will be after several years. And what I want to say to you is that you are never too old to get into new things and learn new things. The biggest mistake that you can make in life is to say, I know it all. No one does. Learners move forward, others slowly fall behind. For me personally, an opportunity to contribute to the nation building in a big way came in 2021 at the age of 67, when I was approached and appointed as head of INSPACE, the Indian National Space Promotion and Authorization Center. Space was a totally new sector for me, an uncharted territory, but clearly a sunrise sector with tremendous potential. The opportunity to make India's mark in global space economy was something that I leapt into with my heart and mind. And I'm amazed to see how the veterans of ISRO and young startups founded by engineering graduates just like you are driving the new technological revolutions in this sector. I'm sure Pixel, Dhruva Space, Skyroot, Agnikul are a few of the names you would be familiar with. For me, so much to learn and so much opportunity to value add. So in conclusion, I want to say that there are four lessons out of many things that I have learned in life, often by making mistakes, that I have left for you to think about. A, first, listen to your heart. Sometimes, let your heart overpower your head. Hard for engineers to do. Live for a superordinate goal. It'll be like a North Star guiding you and aligning your actions towards a bigger purpose. Take big bets. You won't make a dent in the universe without taking risk. And never stop learning. As Henry Ford said, anyone who stops learning is old, whether at 20 or 80. Anyone who keeps learning stays young. And as you embark upon the new chapter of your life, be aware that your journey won't be without its challenges. There will be obstacles to overcome, setbacks to endure, moments of doubt. There'll be those who will doubt your intentions and capabilities. Today, as I witness the remarkable strides that India has made in the last 30 years, I'm filled with a sense of pride and validation of my belief, and also a deep appreciation for the talent and resilience that resides inside each of us. And I truly believe the talent that India has today is better than the talent that we had 30 years ago. And therefore, my friends, next 30 years will be even better than the last 30 years. You enter this convocation hall today as students. You will walk out as aspiring technocrats and visionaries of future India, contributing to our nation's vision of a Viksit Bharat. So congratulations once again, and I wish you all the very best in your future endeavors. May you achieve greatest things and make all of us proud. God bless and Jai Hind.
So I request Chairman Shri Adil Siraj Junal Bhai to present the memento to the chief guest.
I request our director to present the memento to the chairman, BOG.
Mr. Registrar, please propose the number of graduates eligible for the award of the degrees.
Director, sir, I present to you 115 candidates for the award of PhD degree, 116 candidates for the award of M.Tech degrees, 12 candidates for the award of B.Tech M.Tech dual degree, 67 candidates for the award of MSc degree, and 305 candidates for the award of B.Tech degrees to them.
Now all the degree recipients are requested to rise from their seat. Yeah, all the graduate recipients are requested to.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Chairman of the Senate of the Indian Institute of Technology, Ropar, I do hereby admit the duly qualified candidate listed in the scroll for the degree and charge them to prove worthy of the degrees and authorize them to wear the robes of ordained as an insignia of the degree.
I request Dean Postgraduate and Research, Dean Undergraduate, to present the candidates for Award of Medals to Chairman and Director.
I request Chairman BOG and Chief Guest to present medals and certificate to the medal awardee. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the postgraduate student of the Master of Technology in Artificial Intelligence in the year 2023 has been awarded to Zimi Huck. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the postgraduate student of Master of Technology in Biomedical Engineering in the year 2023 has been awarded to Kirti Singh. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the postgraduate students of the Master of Technology in Civil Engineering in the year 2023 has been awarded to Sukh Sahaj Kaur. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the postgraduate student of Master of Technology in Chemical Engineering in the year 2023 has been awarded to Ankit Singh Jadeja. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the postgraduate student of the Master of Technology in Computer Science Engineering in the year 2023 has been awarded to Sajja Vinay Kumar in absentia. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the postgraduate student of the Master of Technology in Electrical Engineering in the year 2023 has been awarded to Surbhi. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA among the postgraduate student of the Master of Technology in Mechanical Engineering in the year 2023 has been awarded to Manpreet Singh in absentia. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the students of BTech MTech Dual Degree in Mechanical Engineering in the 2023 has been awarded to Vikram Shetty in absentia. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA among the postgraduate student of the Master of Science in Chemistry in the year 2023 has been awarded to Sonia in absentia. The Institute Silver Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the postgraduate student of the Master of Science in Mathematics in the year 2023 has been awarded to Arvind Mohandas. The Institute Silver Medal is given for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the postgraduate student of the Master of Science in Physics in the year 2023 has been awarded to Muskan Jain in absentia. Now I request Dean UG to present the candidate for the award of medals to Chairman and Director.
Chairman BOG and Director Sir, the President of India Gold Medal for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the graduating students of Bachelor of Technology in year 2023 has been awarded to Uday Gupta of Computer Science and Engineering. The Director Gold Medal for the best all-round performance amongst the graduating students of Bachelor of Technology in year 2023 has been awarded to Diksha Mittal of Mathematics and Computing. The Institute Silver Medal is given for obtaining the highest CGPA amongst the graduating students under Bachelor of Technology program in their respective discipline for the year 2023. Institute Silver Medal for Bachelor of Technology in Civil Engineering has been awarded to Vasundar Pant. Institute Silver Medal for Bachelor of Technology in Chemical Engineering has been awarded to Mohammad Majar Lalji. Institute Silver Medal for Bachelor of Technology in Electrical Engineering has been awarded to Yash Mittal. Institute Silver Medal for Bachelor of Technology in Mathematics and Computing has been awarded to Hardik Kapoor. Institute Silver Medal for Bachelor of Technology in Mechanical Engineering has been awarded to Arsh Malik. Institute Silver Medal for Bachelor of Technology in Metallurgical and Materials Engineering has been awarded to Harjot Kaur.
Chairman and Director Sir, I present to you PhD student for Best Thesis Award in Sciences and Engineering Discipline. The Best Thesis Award for the year 2023 has been awarded to Ms. Dr. Bhavana Rana from Physics in Sciences. The Best Thesis Award for the year 2023 has been awarded to Dr. Linda Arora from Biomedical Engineering in Engineering in Absentia. So, Director Sir, I present to you 55 candidates in person and 16 in absentia for the award of PhD degree who has duly qualified to receive the degree. Abhishek Kumar, Amanpreet Singh, Anoop Kumar, Arju Narang, Arju Sharma, Vaibhav Kumar Gupta, Bhavana Rana, Chandrasekhar, Daisy Mehta, Dhruv Kumar Goyal, Gaurav Singh, Gopika Sharma, Jeevara Prasad, Hina Shami, Ritab Kishore, Jitendra, Kalyani Agrawal, Madhuluri Anant, Manish Kumar, Manju, Mudasani Satyanarayana, Naveen Kumar, Neha Gupta, Nitin Joshi, Pankaj Gautam, Pardeep Kaur, Piyush Pratap Singh, Pooja R, Prabhjot Singh, Priya Singh Bhakar, Priya Verma, Ram Singh Yadav, Riya Vadva, Rohtash, Sanjeev Sahil Dani, Shagun Kaushal, Shobhit Maheshwari, Shruti S. Phutke, Sirsat A. Vishnu, Somnath Gorai, Sonam, Sumit Saxena, Sunil Gupta, Sunil Sharma, Swati Thakur, Tushita Rohila, Umed Singh, Vaibhav Shah, Vasudev, Veena Yu, V. Satish, Vishal Agrawal, Vishal Singh, Vivek Sethi, Panika Jain, I request head of the department to present Master of Technology and Master of Science degree from their departments.
Director sir, I present to you 11 candidates in person and one in absentia who have duly qualified in the year of 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Technology in Biomedical Engineering. Chirag Singhal. Vibham Kumar Dubey. Josil Kumar. Manoj Kumar. Kirti Singh. Natasha VP. Pramod Yadav. Ranjana Shukla. Srijani Devnath. Sumit Sarkar. And Varun Nair. Thank you.
Director, sir, I present to you 8 candidates in person and 1 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Technology in Chemical Engineering. Can we have Aditi Singh? Ankit Singh Jadeja. G. Nandakumar Gaud. Khyati Aherwal. Lavina Umesh Wagwani. Manu Thakur. Priyanka Saini. Siddhant Saini.
Director, sir, I present to you 7 candidates in person who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Technology in Civil Engineering. Gaurav Singh.
Kashish Pathania. Rajat Lal. Suksehaj Kaur. Vikas Singh. Vishal. Vishal Bashisht.
Director, sir, I present to you 6 candidates in person and 12 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Technology in Computer Science and Engineering. Anshu. Anurag Jaiswal. Ninad. Shivam Singh. Shaurya Gupta. Srinivas P. Director, sir, I present to you 7 candidates in person and 7 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Technology in Artificial Intelligence. Anita Kumari. Avdesh Gaur. Gaurav Sharma. Ishan Tripathi. Pavan Nayak. Pavan Nayak. Zimi Hak. Sumit Gupta. Thank you.
Director, sir, I present to you 22 candidates in person and 9 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Technology in Electrical Engineering. Adarsh Prakash Pandey. Amit Kumar Ratre. Anshit Yadav. Deepak. Dharu Das. Dudhal Ajinkya Anil. Gagan Tiyotia. Gugulotu Nikhil. KM Payal Bharati. Korra Vamshi Krishna. Kaustav Singh. Manika Khadka. Nitish Kumar. Pankaj Kumar Savalia. Rajkumar Baghel. Rangol Pranav Neminath. Sanu Kumar. Sonia Bonwal. Surabhi. Tarun Bharati. Vikas Chauhan. And Virendra Singh. Thank you, sir.
Director, sir, I present to you 16 candidates in person and 9 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Technology in Mechanical Engineering. Ajay D. Patel. Anil Vishwakarma. Ashutosh Singh. Bhavna. Jakka Praveen.
Khushwant Singh Chauhan, Narendra Bahadur, Rahul Gupta, Rajat Kumar, Sachin, Shiva Kumar, Shubham Kumar, Sudhanshu Sharma, Vasaikar Ame Atul Rupa, Veda Marrapu, Vivek Kumar, Director Sir, I present to you 7 candidates in person and 5 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of BTech MTech dual degree in mechanical engineering. Abhishek Gupta, Amit Kumar Chippa, Bhuvnesh Agarwal, Deepansh Khatri, Manjeet Meena, Rishabh Pachoria, Vivek Verma,
Director Sir, I present to you 7 candidates in person and 16 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Science in Chemistry. Amandeep Singh, Divyasha Singh, Pallavi Kumari, Prince Gautam. Shubham Bhatt. Srishti Kamboj. Vishal Mittal.
Director Sir, I present to you 18 candidates in person and 5 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Science in Mathematics. Aravind Mohandas. Deepika N. Drashti Doshi. Gayakwad Akshata Anna. Jason Thomas. Krishan Bajia. Manisha Sehgal. Mehak Preet Kaur. Mohini Satarupa Jena. Pooja. Preeti Rathaur. Rajneesh Kaur. Saksham Setia. Sashi Bala. Seema Prajapat. Suraj Kumar. Swati Tomar. T. Joseph Thangoi Kual Zou.
Director sir, I present to you 9 candidates in person and 12 candidates in absentia who have duly qualified in year 2023 to receive the degree of Master of Science in Physics. Adarsh Tripathi. Anjali. Balram Bhardwaj. Prasant. Priyansi Kausik. Ravi Prakash Saini. Seema Khoja. Shivam Kumar Yadav. Vivek.
Now I request the head of departments to present BTEC degrees from their departments.
Director, sir, I present to you 11 candidates in person and 8 in absentia who are duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Chemical Engineering. Can we have Anmol Das? Hardik Rana. Mansi Dilip Sardesai. Mankaran Singh. Magpreet Chopra. Mohammad Mazhar Lalji. Nalin. Shivam Pandey. Shubham Sanavane. Suryansh Pratap Singh. Tanish Bagra.
Director sir, I present to you 30 candidates in person, 4 candidates in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Civil Engineering. Aman Kumar. Amit Kumar. Anuj Pillai. Anurag Meena. Bhavna Kumari Meena. Bholesh Mittal. Dev Kukreja. Harish. Hitesh Meena. Jaydeep Singh. Kambale Nilkant Rameshwar. Kanha Singhania. Manish Mahala. Mohit Kasania. Mukesh Yadav. Nirmal Bisu. Pankaj Drolia. Pradeep Chaudhary. Pranav Guglani. Priya Kumari. Rahul. Rahul Matolia. Raj Mohini Soni. Ridham Preet Singh Mehal.
Ruhin Zeba. Satanshu Pathak. Suliya Darshit Kumar. Tushar Chaudhary. Vamshu. Vasundhara Pant.
Director, sir, I present to you 64 candidates in person and 15 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Computer Science and Engineering. Arushi. Ayush Sabarwal. Abhishek Chaudhary. Abhishek Kumar. Aditi Agarwal. Aditya Agarwal. Akhil Arya. Anand. Aniket Mangal. Anshu Kumar. Apurv Rathod. Ashish Kumar. Ayush Verma. Bellam Jayant. Bharat Sharma. Bhumika. Chiranjeev Dutt. Dheeresh Kumar Singh. Het Fadia Rakesh Kumar. Ganesh Agarwal. Gautam Manocha. Gurukripal Singh. Harsh Priyadarshi. Harshvardhan Kumar. Himanshi Nim. Himanshu Yadav. Jagadale Sangram Rajendra. Jaglaik Makkar. Keshav Goyal. Keshav Krishna. Kritika Goyal. Kshitish Arora. Kushagra Agarwal. Manan Singhal. Muskan Gupta. Nema Ram Meghwal. Nikita Meena. Nitish Goyal. Nupur Rati. Rajashekar. Piyush Prasannan. Pradeep Kumar. Praveen Kumar. Priyanshu Sharma. Rajesh Ronival. Rhythm Jain. Rishabh Jain. Ritik Garg. Sahadev. Sakshat Chahal. Shikhar Soni. Shobit Prashant Nair. Dhruv Solanki Ritesh Kumar. Sudhanshu Kumar. Tanmay Aaron. Tanuj Maheshwari. Tarun Singla. Uday Gupta. Urvi Gupta. Vanshal Singh. Vasu Bansal. Vicky Kumar. Vishavam Datta. Yash Priyadarshi. Shivani Kumari. Thank you.
Director sir, I present to you 56 candidates in person and 17 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Electrical Engineering. Abhishek Meena. Aditya Bharuntia. Ajay Raj Meena. Ajit Yadav. Aman Bhattan. Amritansh Rai. Anish Shelgaonkar. Ankit Kumar. Anshul Negi. Anurag. Ayushi Prajapati. Balwinder. Balwan Singh. Bhupen. Chennamolla Vinay. Chunduri Naga Venkata Sai Manoj. D.V. Sahan. Devang Singh. Ganiyu Sandhu. Gharmanshu Patanjali. Hitesh Kharia. Karthik Singh. Kashish Jain. Kirti Singh. Lakshit Satija. Madhur Jain. Manav Mago. Mayank Singh. Navneet Singh Kevadia. Nitin Kumar Rathor. Pankaj. Pankhuri Saxena. Priyanka Kotta. Priyasha Pratap. Ritek Saxena. Ria. Rohit Dagar. Sachin Yadav. Sayam Bharara. Saksham Gupta. Samarth Benawat. Sarthak Singh. Saurabh Mehar. Shivam Kumar. Shivam Patidar. Shreya Gupta. Shruti Pavan Kumar Balwani. Siddhartha Garg. Somil Jain. Swapnil Saurav. Tanishk Gupta. Tanishk Vaishnav. Tushar Jain. Yash Jain. Yash Kumar. Yash Mittal. And Nakul Ranjan.
Director sir, I present to you 14 candidates in person and 5 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Mathematics and Computing. Anirudh Sanghi. Anushka Modi. Ashish Sharma. Boni Akhil Sairam. Deepak Meena. Diksha Mittal. Gatari Vivek. Ghatke Shriyans Sambhaji Rao. Gurjot Singh. Hardik Kapoor. Harshit Bansal. Rishi Johri. Ria Lamba. And Srijan Keshri.
Director sir, I present to you 51 candidates in person and 11 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Mechanical Engineering. Avesh Saini. Abhishek Sagar. Akshay Kumar. Akshit Mehra. Aman Kumar. Ankur Mittal. Anshuman Pandey. Anu Agrawal. Arsh Malik. Aryan Anand. Ashfaq. Ashwin Raj. Avinash Kumar Meena. Bharat Kumawat. Bhumika Pal. Birajdar Chinmay Chandrakant. Chadive Satish Chandra Reddy. Chetan Kumar. Gagan Chaturvedi. Gaurav Tiwari. Gautam Sharma. Gupta Ritik Rajesh Kumar. Harshpreet Singh. Hemant Meena. Himanshu Dhiman. Ishan Rajesh Sawant. Katta Joseph Babu. Kaustubh Kumar Singh. Khushi Malviya. Lovish Garg. Manshu Malik. Muhammad Atahar Hassan. Nishant Kumar Singh. Pranshu Mehra. Priyank Patel. Raghav Verma. Riya Gupta. Rohan Kumar. Sanskar Vyas. Sanyukta Marandi. Shanu Singroha. Shashwat Patidar. Shubhangi Singhal. Sujal Bansal. Swami Kedar Sharan. Tanmay Gambhir. Taneru Sai Siva Naga Bhavani. Tushar Raj. Varsha Singh. Vishal Saini. Yogesh Kumar Kumawat. Thank you.
Director, sir, I present to you 13 candidates in person and 6 in absentia who have duly qualified in the year 2023 to receive the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Metallurgical and Materials Engineering. Adarsh Aryan. Ashima. Bobby Kuhikar. Charvak Bhushan Ambade. Gokul Nandan. Harjot Kaur. Harshvardhan Shevakramani. Kanupriya Goyal. Prem Dayal. Rishabh Jain. Sachit Anand. Sanchit Gupta. Shyam Sundar Verma.
Let the record of the degrees to be presented by the registrar to the Chairman Senate and Chairman BOG for the signatures.
So we are almost in the end now. You can relax. So we can take an oath. Let the oath be administered.
Now I request all candidates receiving their degree to rise and repeat the oath. I hereby pledge that it shall be my constant endeavor to scrupulously be honest in the discharge of my duties as engineer and scientist, to uphold the dignity of the individual and the integrity of the profession, to utilize my knowledge of technology and science for the glory of the institute, in the service of the country and mankind at large.
Now I request our chairman, BOG, to declare the convocation closed.
I declare the 12th convocation of IIT Ropar closed. Thank you.
भाग्य विधाता जय हे